Hey everyone, Shawn, Clement here, Wisdom in Golf at the fabulous Royal Quebec Golf Club. And with the new information we get out of the GC Quad, there's all kinds of lessons that we keep getting every year. Last year it was, hey, my driver and my three wood have the same club speed. Why do I need to have the driver at the length of 45 and a half when at 43, I'm getting the same club head speed? So I bring the driver down to 43 and a half and I'm benefiting from a lot of accuracy and I'm still getting the same distances that I'm accustomed to. Now today I just noticed that gripping down on my 42 and a half inch three wood to 39 inches, which is the length of my three iron, I'm getting the same distance. But I feel way more comfortable over the ball. So the question is, do we grip down or not? That is the question. You don't want to miss this show, not one bit. We noticed there's 98,000 of you watching my channel that haven't even subscribed to the channel yet. What the heck are you waiting for? You gotta press that subscribe button and then let us know what you feel about the videos. Leave us a comment, question down below. Give us a like because you're obviously watching our videos. So we really appreciate that. Helps us out a great deal. And then we can bring you even better content next time. Let's get to it. So I'm gonna hit a couple of shots with full length three wood. You'll notice that carry is going to be around 250 yards and a certain amount of ball speed. So let's get to it. I'm doing my straight draw. There's my intermediate point. I've got my grass blades in front of the ball that I'm sending in that direction with some nice momentum. Oh yeah, that should be very representative. So 108 ball club speed, 244 carry, decent backspin, about 3,300 RPM. So there's a really nice straight fade on that ball right there. Now we're gonna go and grip down an inch and a half on this 42 and a half inch three wood. So I'm basically only an inch longer than my three iron right now. And let's see what happens. So I find that when I grip down, I feel like I can be over the ball a little bit better and it gives me a little bit more leverage. So I'm gonna go ahead and perform the same task. Good shot there. 106 miles an hour and 242 carry. We were at, and that's 151 ball speed. How about that? So let's look at how this works with the driver, okay? So I got an even better special for you. Is it better to have a 45 and a half inch driver grip down on that, or is it better to do 44 inches and not grip down? So, and then I'll even grip down on the driver and we'll experiment with that. So we'll have three different distances with the driver. Let's check it out. Okay, so I'm gonna go with my little power fade, my stock 44 inch driver. Oh, that felt good. So we got 110 miles an hour. Right in the center of the face, 281 carry and about, it's 159 ball speed, 160 ball speed. There's my classic, you know, power fade with the driver. All right, now I'm gonna grip down about an inch and a half on the driver. So technically, I'm basically down to my three wood length at 42 and a half inches. So let's see what happens with this. 113 miles an hour, right in the center of the club face. My ball speed is exactly the same at 159. My carry's at 277, my spin's just a little more up. So basically, no change. Now, just to show you, here's my LA golf shaft, which is pretty freaking fabulous, by the way. And then you can see that it's an inch and a half shorter than my 45 and a half inch Callaway shaft here. I put a 65 gram, slightly lighter shaft in there at 45 and a half. And let's see what happens if I get a little more speed on this thing. That was still a little off center at 114. So I'm dancing around the center of the face and my ball speed is still 3-4 miles an hour less. Now we can see that at full length, it's not worth it for me to have this shaft because what I gain in a mile an hour or two, I'm losing as far as accuracy and center contact with the club face. And so my efficiency, my smash factor goes down, my ball speed goes down, and my overall distance is about the same, but not as accurate. So I'm gonna grip down on this thing now and see what happens. See if I can get more gains in speed with a lighter shaft. And I'm gonna grip down inch and a half to my, that would be my normal driver now. Let's see the difference. Oh yeah. 114, center face contact, 1.39 smash now. 158 ball speed, 288 carry. And there's one thing I want to mention to you guys, is when you grip down on the club, it reduces the spin. You get a reduction in spin. So if you're gonna hit one into the wind, you wanna reduce the spin, please practice gripping down on the club. So I noticed my spin has gone down a little bit, about 200 RPM. So that'll give me a little more control in the wind. Now, bottom line, there's a reason why a lot of tour professionals prefer gripping down. For them, it gives them a sensation of better leverage. And I'm really kind of changing my tune on the full swing version of that. Now, when it comes to short game, I don't like to grip down because A, I don't go lower than an 8-iron in length, a stock 8-iron. So the shortest club in my bag is my, from the 9-iron through my wedges, is my 9-iron length. Anything lower than that, and I feel like I'm uncomfortably over the ball and I'm a little bit off balance. So as far as short game is concerned, I don't like gripping down. And I don't want you to grip down in your short game if you're looking for more control. What we want when it comes to chip shots is use the weight of the arms and club. So we feel the weight of the arms and club hanging from the shoulders, and we're letting the weight of the arms and club shave grass in the direction we want to go. So when I'm using weight, I'm using momentum. And now I can really judge how much momentum I need to land the ball where I want to land it. If you're gripping down because you feel that you can control the club more so you can manipulate it better, then you're really doing yourself a disservice. However, when it comes to the full swing, you definitely want to try gripping down on the club, especially if club speed is an issue, because the shorter club, you get more over the ball and it's much easier to sling. So as I get older, I'm starting to feel, you know, the need to grip down only because it feels like I can sling it better. And that's gonna give me some nice benefits when it comes to delivering a shot toward the target with ease. And we notice that as far as velocity is concerned, there is little to no difference as the club head speed is concerned. However, consistency-wise, there is a significant difference. So hope you guys enjoyed that, and we'll see you next week. Yeah.